Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Duck's Pokemon. My name is Zach, but you can just call me Ducky. And in today's video, we have got another Celebrations opening. I know, y'all, we have been getting a lot of Celebrations openings lately, and that makes me so happy. So this is from the Target haul that I got a while back, where I waited over an hour to get some Pokemon cards. But luckily, I was able to get a Celebrations Elite Trainer box, which if you guys have not already seen that video, or two videos actually, you can go check those out. Super awesome pulls. Really, really happy we were able to grab that. But I was also able to grab this Lance's Charizard V-Box. So I got this for a price of $20. It's not a terrible price for what we're getting. We're getting a literal Zard, and everyone loves Zard. So we've got this going on today, and it's just going to be a one-and-done opening. We're just going to be opening up all these packs and seeing what we can get. So far, I'm almost done with the full set of Celebrations, the 25 cards that make up the first set. There's also the Classic Collection, which I'm nowhere near completing, but we're getting close to the full Celebration set. I'm only missing the Zamazenta V, and of course the Gold Mew, because that's like the hardest thing to pull. I love how there's like a little 25 logo on the plastic here, even though I wish they didn't have to use so much plastic. All right, let's get this opened up and see what we got going on here. Oh, so much plastic. This is my first collection box opening in the college studio. I don't know why that's momentous or anything. Here's your code card, 1, 2, and done. We've got this gorgeous Lance's Charizard V promo. Just learning Flamethrower and whatever. Super powerful Pokemon. Love to see it. We're going to put that as the star of the show today, even though it's going to get dethroned. I'm sure it is. We've got a Wumbo Jumbo Lance's Charizard V that doesn't even fit on the screen because it's so Wumbo Jumbo. And I genuinely have no place to put it. I can put it like right here for now, but like I'm going to have to put cards on top of it, which is kind of awkward, but whatever, it happens. So we've got those cards already. I don't know why they include these, but we also have this little informational pamphlet on what the owner's Pokemon is. I don't know, it's just about what the card history, I guess. It's interesting. I don't really care much for it. I think it's just a waste of paper, but if you guys like it, you know, that's your opinion. You're totally entitled to that. So much plastic. There's another plastic thing here. I don't know why I'm complaining about plastic today. It's just, I don't know. I just don't feel like it should be that, you should have that much plastic in these products, because it's very easy to not, you know? All right, so we have only got 4 Celebrations packs today, 2 regular booster packs. We've got the Darkness Ablaze and Battle Styles, but then we've got ourselves our 4 gorgeous Celebrations packs. All right, let's actually just get right into it. I am so sick of talking. I've been talking for all day today already, so I'm just gonna, we're gonna power through it. So we're gonna do Battle Styles, 2 Celebrations, Darkness Ablaze, 2 Celebrations. And that's how we're going to do it today. Really simple, nice little opening here. And hopefully we can get ourselves some swanky pulls. I don't know why I said swanky. That's just weird. All right. If y'all haven't already, please just click the like button. Make sure that we get the best luck that we can on this video. You know, scroll down, click that little like button. Super easy, super simple, super fun, right? It's super fun to click the like button. The dopamine stream that you get from clicking the like button is immeasurable, I promise. And here we go with pack number 1. Battle Styles. I am not a huge fan of Battle Styles just because I never get good pulls from Battle Styles. 1, 2, and done. But I may like it a little bit more if I ever get some pulls from it. 4 to the front. And here we go. Off with our first pack. We've got ourselves a new and improved Electric Energy, a Seadra, a Weepinbell, an EXP Share, a Frillish, Houndour pulling a big rock. I never even noticed. That's a huge rock. Houndour, how are you doing that? Scatterbug in the wind. Honedge. Gligar. A Reverse Holo. Uncommon. That looks like a rare, but it's not. It's a really nice artwork, though. Cacturne. And our rare. It's a non-holographic Inkeldur. What did I say, y'all? What did I say? So, Lance's Charizard is actually going to have to just, like, go off to the side. And these guys just go back here for now. Okay, so we got rid of our dud pack. That's okay. We didn't need a good pull from that pack, although I would have liked it. But now, we've got our first Celebrations pack up. Let's see if we can pull something amazing, something new. Y'all already know, if you've been watching this channel a lot, that I'm going for that Zekrom full art. That is my number one pull from the set. I've already pulled the Charizard. Of course, I'd like to pull the Blastoise and Venusaur, but again, those aren't priorities. Priorities are the Zekrom full art and 1, 2, and done. And probably the gold Mew, just because I need it for the set. Okay, so here we go. Our first pack of celebrations. We have a Zekrom, a Dialga. Here's our classic collection, if we have one. Oof, a Lugia. All right, please just don't be a dud pack. It's a dud pack. Okay, we're starting things off with a dud pack with the Professor's Research. 4 regular holos. That's how you know it's a dud pack. Regular holographic cards. Okay. Well, at least we got all of our dud packs out of the way, which means that there's only bangers from here, right, guys? Only absolute bangers of packs. So here we go. Pack number 2 of celebrations. I gotta take this slow. I gotta enjoy this opening because this is the last celebrations opening for me in a while, I think. Unless I'm able to get back into the old studio. 1, 2, and done. I may be able to. Not 100% sure. We will see. All right. We've got a Cosmog, a Reshiram. Here's our classic collection card, if there is one. Another birthday Pikachu. Okay, I already pulled this in our last opening, but I guess it's okay to double up on this one. This is a nice, it's a fun card. It's just such a fun card, a very unique card from the era of Pokemon that it was from. And our rare is a Surfing Pikachu V. Okay, okay, so here's what we're gonna do. Lance's Charizard, you go over here. Can't even see you. Birthday Pikachu, you are number 1. And Pikachu, Surfing Pikachu V, you're over here. All right, so I guess we started things off with a double banger, so that makes up for our dud pack, I guess. But that's cool. So, cool. We got a double banger, and we also got 2 doubles, but it's fine. It's fine. I'm going to collect as much of the set as I can. And if I get doubles, that just means I can sell the doubles and buy more products, honestly. So here we go. Darkness Ablaze. Y'all, I wouldn't even care what I got from Celebrations if I pulled the Charizard VMAX from this pack. Probably won't, 1, 2, and done. Again, I've discussed this in a previous video, but I think the Pokemon Company is killing the pull rates on sets, the main sets, like the not Celebration sets in these Celebrations boxes, because the Celebrations boxes are just very hit-heavy. Like, you're able to get so many pulls from the Celebrations boxes, so they decided to, like, make sure that you didn't get a lot of good pulls from the packs that had 10 cards. I don't know. That's just a theory of mine, but I don't know. I could be making it up. We got a Vanillite, a Trapinch, a Yarn Trapinch, to be precise, a Teddy Ursa, Pansier, Irreverse Holo Wishiwashi, and our rare is a non-holographic Thievul. See what I'm saying, y'all? I think in my other opening of Celebrations that had regular packs in it, I was only able to pull 1 ultra rare out of 5 packs, and now I'm at 1 ultra rare out of 7 of these regular packs. But now we are down to our final 2 Celebrations packs. This is getting me nervous, y'all. If I don't get to pull anything new, I'm going to be a little discouraged. But it's okay, because it's still worth it, because this set is just fun to open. Getting pulls all the time is what makes this set so fun. It's like Hidden Fates on steroids. If y'all remember, Hidden Fates had so many different pulls that you could just, like, get all the time. And that's kind of the case, 1, 2, and done, with Celebrations, where you're able to get so many different pulls all the time, and it never gets boring. So we've got ourselves a Dialga. Another Dialga. Okay, that's weird. Here's our Classic Collection card, if any. Nope, Cosmoem. Okay, no Classic Collection. And our rare is the Zamazenta V. So we got it. We actually got it. A new card for the set. I know this is like a worthless card, maybe a $2 card, but I don't care because I needed it to complete the set. I'm one card away from completing the main Celebration set. That is so awesome. I'm actually going to dethrone Birthday Pikachu because I already have it. So I don't need to celebrate it as much as I need to give, you know, the spotlight to Zamazenta V. Very beautiful artwork too. I don't even know what's happening in the background. It's just like floating in stones or something. I don't know. But that's really cool. We were able to pull the Zamazenta V. And that brings us to the last pack of celebrations. So if you're new to the channel, I'm about to do a little bit of a ritual. And it's a little weird, but you're going to have to bear with me here. Also, thank you for checking out the channel. But if you are a recurring viewer, you know what I'm about to do. I'm going to send you all the good vibes. All the good vibes have been sent to you, the Duck Squad, and all I ask in return is that you give me all the good luck, and there are three ways you can do that. Number one, like this video. It's so easy. You scroll down, you click the like button just like that, and you're done. Number two, comment on this video. You can comment anything you want as long as it's appropriate. Maybe congratulate me on almost completing the main set. Number three, if you are not already subscribed, please consider clicking that subscribe button. If you are already subscribed, click that notification bell to be notified every time I post Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays at 3 p.m. Central Time. And without further ado, my last pack of celebrations, maybe for a while, maybe not for a while. We'll see. I'll try my best. But I've got a lot of product coming down the pipeline, so it's not like we're gonna have to worry about having enough product, you know? I'm so nervous, y'all. I'm so nervous. Can we pull? You know what? I do this every time, and I get it wrong every time, but I'm going to call that our pull is going to be the Blastoise from base set. One, two, and done. The base set Blastoise reprint. That'd be so cool. All right. We've got ourselves a Kyogre, a Cosmog. Here is our class collection card, if any. Please be a class collection card. That's really unfortunate. That really hurts. That really, really hurts. And the final card of this video is the Surfing Pikachu V again. All right, y'all, that's kind of an L. This was a dud box, to say the least. It's not even gonna stay. Okay, it is gonna stay. So, a quick recap. We got another birthday Pikachu, which I'm not complaining about. I actually really like that. But two Surfing Pikachus that I already have, which is not very cool. The Lance's Charizard V, which is new, and the Zamazenta V, which is also new. So overall, I would say today is a semi-success, a semi-failure, but it's okay. We have more celebrations coming down the pipeline soon, just not too soon. I'm going to miss opening this set in the meantime. But anyways, that is just about going to do it for the video today. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Always, always, always do those things. It makes me happy, and hopefully my videos make you just a little bit happier. Remember, I get the bad pulls, so you don't have to. And with all that being said, I'm OctoDuxPokemon, and I'm out.